Welcome back. I was just doing some reviewing. I was going over the website of JW.org and I thought, what? So I thought I'd better make a video and show you guys what I found. There, that fixes my lighting when I do that. Okay, well, we'll get right into it. Here it is. Let me just see if I can get that up better for you. This is right off their website. Is truth important anymore? But if you go back, you look at their website right now, this is what you get. The growing affliction of loneliness. Well, just looking at this whole surface, of course, they do this to appeal to newcomers. Maybe someone's looking on their site for the first time, and they want to make their site look like, it's just a normal, innocent, religious site. And that they're concerned about your loneliness. But this organization kicks people out. They shun and disfellowship people. There's people out there that are very lonely that they put there. So for them to do an article on the growing affliction of loneliness is completely hypocritical. I'm not even gonna look at that article. Now, this one, is truth important anymore? That one caught my attention, because that's what one of the things that brought me into this organization was that word truth and the misapplication of that word. Okay, so when we look over this article, truth, what's the first thing that comes to your mind when you think of the word truth? Well, I know what comes to my mind is John 14 and 6, but it's not in this article. And they go on to talk about truth. Does truth even exist? They say yes, the Bible uses the word truth. They talk about it, teaches that Jehovah God is the source of absolute truth. This is what they teach. This is blasphemy. Because this is from the Old Testament. This is old stuff. This is not new stuff. And by the way, when they use Jehovah in the New Testament, it's put there. It's not there originally. We're not going to use the New World Translation because it has 231 errors in the New Testament just by inserting the word Jehovah. So then they go on to, how can you find truth? Well, they say the Bible, you can confirm what we learn from Matthew. Well, what's in Matthew? He said to him, you must love Jehovah. It's not what it says. We're going to look at that in another Bible right now. So let's take a look at that. He said to him, you must love Jehovah your God with your whole heart, with your whole soul, your whole mind. This is the greatest, the first command. Does the Bible really say that? Well, here we're going to look at the, what version is this? This is a New English Version, Matthew 22. And here's what a real Bible says. And he said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and the greatest command. The second is like, you must love your neighbor as yourself. So the Lord, is the Lord Jehovah? No, the Lord is not Jehovah. Jesus never ever used the word Jehovah. Jehovah, Yahweh, the Tetragrammaton does not appear once in the Christian Greek scriptures. So here's what Jehovah's Witnesses did. They tell us, you go right to their Bible right here. This is Appendix A, A5, the divine name in the Christian Greek scriptures. Here's how they did it. Bible scholars acknowledge that God's personal name, as represented by the Tetragrammaton, appears almost 7,000 times in the original text of the Hebrew scriptures. That's the Old Testament. However, many feel that it did not appear in the original text of the Greek scriptures. Well, they couldn't find it. None of the It's not that they didn't feel it, they couldn't find it on early manuscripts. It didn't exist because it wasn't used. Jehovah, Yahweh, was not Jesus God. It says, for this reason, most modern English Bibles do not use the name Jehovah when translating the so-called New Testament. Even when translating quotations from the Hebrew scriptures in which the Tetragrammaton appears, most translators use Lord rather than God's personal name. Now, the New World Translation of the Holy Scriptures does not follow this common practice. It uses the name Jehovah a total of 237 times in the Christian Greek scriptures. Here's the point, guys. In deciding to do this, the translator, which is the watchtower, took into consideration two important factors. Number one, the Greek manuscripts we process today are not the originals. Of thousands of copies in existence today, most were made at least two centuries after the originals were composed. And number two, by the time that those copy manuscripts either replaced a tetragrammaton, you see, None of the, they can't find it. Any of the Dead Sea Scrolls, any of the old copies, it's not there. What is there is what they're saying. They're, it's not replaced. No one's replaced the Tetragrammaton with Kairos. No one's done that. It's just that Jehovah was not their God. Kairos, the Lord, El, Elyon, the God above Jehovah, is the God above the heavens. Jehovah is the God of the Israelites. He's one of the pantheon gods, and he was given, allotted to the nation of Israel, Judah. So when Jesus came, he set matters straight. He made it clear in John 8:44 that his God was not the Pharisees' God. The Pharisees worshiped Jehovah, Yahweh. They used the old Hebrew scriptures. They only went in their temple once a year to say it to themselves. And no one knows how to pronounce that name. There's no one on earth that knows the real pronunciation of that name. It's all just kind of guessing. So here, let's keep on. The New World Translation, the Translation Committee, here it is. The New World Translation Committee, they determined that there is compelling evidence that the Tetragrammaton did appear in the original manuscripts, and it was based on this. So they based it on copies of the Hebrew scriptures contained throughout the text. Show us, Watchtower, show us that your people went down, found these original checks, show us the pictures. It's not there in none of the original texts. The Watchtower doesn't have scholars. They don't have Bible translators. They don't have theologians that really understand all the old history. They just take it and they do what they think. Now, in the days of Jesus and his apostles, the Tetragrammaton also appeared in Greek translations. They're saying, show me. I don't see it anywhere. They say that that Jesus often referred to God's name and made it known to others. He didn't. Jesus didn't do that. I have made your name manifest to the men in whom of the world. There's nowhere in the Bible that shows Jesus using God's name. So what we have here is the Translation Committee of the Bible and Tract Society. They determined that there's compelling evidence. They figured that this word Jehovah should be put into the New into the Bible. So they took out all the words God and Lord, and they just stuck in the Tetragrammaton. They stuck it in. Now, the way I read that from the Bible, if you change anything according to Revelation or add anything, you're going to go to hell. Well, you're going to have to deal with Christ because you screwed around with what he determined was what he wanted to see. So the Jehovah's Witness Bible is the most inaccurate Bible on this earth. And I'm going to show you how they do this Bible. Let's get right back to my news studio. Now, how they do this Bible is right here. They admit that they know nothing. Here it is.
And also, the governing body is neither inspired nor infallible. And so it can err in doctrinal matters or in organizational direction. Well, knowing this, then, we are not embarrassed about adjustments that are made, nor is an apology needed for not getting it exactly right previously. We understand this is how Jehovah operates. He reveals matters gradually when it is needed.
Okay, so there you got it. They're not inspired. They're just guessing. And they're saying that Jehovah's giving this information to them, but they're not inspired. So how can Jehovah give you information if you're not inspired? You know, these guys talk a double-edged tongue. So anyways, there's nowhere in this article, we're going to go back to this article. There's nowhere in this article that they talk about the truth being Jesus. They talk about the truth as Jehovah. So why is lying so common today? Well, they're lying here. In our time, which the Bible calls last days, Satan is misleading people. Satan is misleading the Jehovah's Witnesses. It's the only thing I can think of. Because why are they twisting the Bible? They say, why is the truth important? Those worshiping God must worship him with spirit and truth. So worshiping Jehovah. They make this all about Jehovah. You see, there's not one scripture here that I can find Not the one I'm looking for. Now, they talk about John 8 and 44, the devil is a liar and the father of the lie. Well, let's really look at that scripture. Jesus said to the Pharisees, you are from your father, the devil. That's what Jesus said to the Pharisees. Now, the Pharisees worshiped Yahweh. And Jesus says, you wish to do the desires of your father, the devil. That one was a murderer when he began, and he did not stand fast in the truth, because the truth is not in him. And when he speaks the lie, he speaks according to his own disposition, because he is a liar and the father of the lie. So here you got this God Jehovah, who killed all these people in the flood, perhaps, who killed all these people at Sodom and Gomorrah, wiped out all these cities. Even the governing body today says we could have sent missionaries in and probably sucked a few people out of Sodom and Gomorrah. So that's why we're not going to judge them now. You see, they're not judging them no more. But Jehovah did that. That's their father. He's the father that is a murderer and a killer. Jesus, God, was not about killing. But Jehovah was jealous. Jesus didn't like Jehovah. It's right there. They don't read the whole scripture. What do they say out of it? They take the devil as a liar and the father the lie. They cherry pick these scriptures. They don't read them and they don't get the depth of the meaning out of them. So meaning, they say Satan the devil told the first lie as the ultimate source of lying. That's not what I read there. I read that Jesus was talking to the Pharisees, if you go into that, and he was condemning them. Their father Yahweh was from the devil. That's what Jesus said. So you read it yourself. So that's how I read the scriptures. John 8 and 32 says the truth will set you free. They say the meaning, the truth that Jesus taught can free us from the ignorance, superstition, religion. See the article, the truth will set you free. See how they mix that up? They're trying to make Jehovah the truth, but yet they're trying to throw Jesus in there a little bit too. So let's go to the Bible tool, and let's see what the Bible tool says when we plug in the word truth. It's very, very easy to do. Just plug it in, truth. And pulls up the scriptures. The first scripture that comes up is right here. I'm going to pull up a different display so you can see it. So the first scripture comes up is John 14 and 6. Jesus says to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the truth, not Jehovah. Jesus. That's what the Bible says. That's what Jehovah's Witness Bible says. But they don't show it. So Jesus says he's the truth. The next verse, John 8 and 32, Jesus says, once you know the truth, once you know Jesus, the truth or Jesus will set you free. You see, the watchtower makes it like they have the truth, like the watchtower is the truth. And once you know the watchtower's truth, the truth will set you free from all the religious dogma out there. That's what I was taught from the old Blue Bomb truth book that they started with back in the early 70s. So I came in the 80s. That's what they started with me, but it was a complete twist of this word truth. So once you can dick around with the word truth and make it the watchtower's truth or Jehovah, because watchtower equals Jehovah, then you've eliminated Jesus, or you've really mixed the hell out of the people. But it's quite simple. Jesus is the truth. It's that simple. It's not Jehovah, and it's not the watchtower. John 16 and 3 says, when the Spirit of truth comes, when Jesus comes, his Spirit comes, he will guide you into all truth, for he will not speak on his own authority, but whoever he hears, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. So this is, you see, once we're talking to Jesus' truth, everything becomes clear in the Bible. But we have to separate Jehovah and Jesus. And the watchtower has bastardized their Bible by putting Jehovah in there, New Testament, 231 times illegally. It's a bastardized version of the Bible. It's the most inaccurate Bible on earth. So let's get right back to the Jehovah's Witness article, the truth. We've debunked that. They really twisted this around for their people. Okay, let's take a look at the next article, A Real Hope for a Better Tomorrow. Another one that they just butchered. Now, they start out by saying, are you optimistic about the future? Many people try to remain positive despite serious problems we face today. But can we realistically expect things to get yet better? Yes, the Bible gives us solid hope. So they go on to talk about that. What hope does the Bible provide? They talk about problems for the homeless. Now, if we really want to get into it, James 1 and 29, 27 says to help the orphans and the widows if you're going to be a religion approved by God, approved by Christ. They don't do that. You see, the homeless, Jehovah's Witnesses, the most they'll do is give the homeless a pamphlet on the street, and it'll say, hey, homeless, in the new system here, the Bible says they will build houses and you can live in them. Join our religion. And the homeless says, I'm just hungry. And then they go on to the next homeless. So they don't look after the homeless. Why are they even talking about the homeless here? They will build houses and, you know, Watchtower, get real. If you're gonna do charity work and you want to be a charity religion, Watchtower, go out and help the homeless like all the other religions do. Problem, unemployment and poverty. Well, Watchtower makes that with all their people. No one can get a higher education to make more money. So everyone ends up in poverty. And then they get thrown out of that religion. And any ties, if they're doing real estate and their clientele is within the religion, they lost it all because now they're disfellowshipped and shunned. So that problem is injustice right here. See, we're talking all about Watchtower's problems. And they try to portray this as the world's problems when this is Watchtower's problems. Problems with malnutrition and hunger. Well, Watchtower could be doing what other religions do. I don't like the Mormons because they hide child pedophilia under clergy penitent privilege. But I'll tell you what, the Mormons gave $1 billion, just $1 billion, this last year over to a bunch of charities. They didn't control the money. Well, I think they did control some of it, but they gave $1 billion to charity, to different various charities, food banks, all kinds of stuff, just to help them out $1 billion. The Mormon church did. The Catholics, they run all kinds of nursing homes, hospitals. I don't know if they built that all on their money, but it certainly has. There's a lot in Alberta here. There's lots of Catholic hospitals, Catholic nursing homes, and anybody can go and stay in these nursing homes. You don't have to be part of the church. I went and had medical procedures done in the Catholic hospital. They're all doctors. A lot of the doctors don't, they're not even part of the Catholic faith. It's not like that. They just put their money toward helping build a hospital. You see, Watchtower doesn't do anything like that. Problem, crime and violence. Well, Watchtower hides crime. They hide serious pedophilia crime within their organization. So they don't have the right to talk about crime and violence out there when they have this problem within their own religion. Problem with war. Well, Watchtower's at war with every country. They're suing Spain. They're suing Norway. They're suing everyone. Watchtower is at war. Problem, sickness and disease. Well, Watchtower people are dying because they can't take medical treatment that may involve blood. Watchtower has twisted the scriptures, and we did it on a recent blood video. You can see the whole thing. But they twist it, and it's not even scriptural what they're doing here. So problems, damage to the environment. I like this one. Watchtower does nothing to plant trees. All the other religions, they have tree planting days. Every other organization on earth, they care about the earth. Watchtower doesn't. They don't give a crap. Is the hope the Bible offers to us good to be true? God is trustworthy. God has power to solve our problems. This is all fluff. How will hope come about? It's all garbage. God's kingdom, when will this hope be fulfilled? Well, they don't know. They've predicted so many end time dates that are false. It's completely, completely wrong. How can the hope the Bible offers help you today? Well, you can read the Bible just like I do. You go right here, you plug in a word you want to know about truth. It gives you the honest answer, John 14 and 6. It doesn't give you all of this Watchtower crap where you got to decipher it all through this big article and then you're lied to. You see, you can't get the truth out of their articles. You can read through this whole thing. It should be right here. Jesus is truth. John 14 and 6. Just like the Bible tool shows. That's what the Bible shows. Jesus is truth. So folks, that's the end of my review today. That's how I review the Watchtower. Don't ever let that website suck you in because it's just full of twists and lies. So that's all I have to say today. So we'll see you guys next time. Bye for now.